So welcome students, let us go on with the problem number 6 in your exercise. See, what is the problem? Consider an electron traveling with a speed of V0 and entering into an uniform electrical field E, which is perpendicular to that of the initial velocity V0 as shown in the figure. Ignoring the gravity, uptime, the electron acceleration, velocity and position as a function of time. So how to calculate the velocity, final velocity, then acceleration and the position of the electron with respect to time? See, what are the given concepts? We know the charge of the electron. So let us consider the charge of the electron as minus E. Charge of the electron. Charge of the electron, I am taking it as minus E. Then electrical field is given. Let us consider this electrical field as capital E, which is acting from lower plate to upper plate. So I am writing it as J cap. Then what is the velocity given? The initial velocity with which the electron is in motion is considered to be V0 and acting along the positive x axis. So I am taking it as I cap. Now, what are the concepts asked? You are asked to calculate what is the acceleration, what is the final velocity, and what is the position with respect to what is the position with respect to time. First of all, in order to calculate the acceleration, I am calculating what is the force experienced by the electron inside the electrical field. See, in between the two plates, you are having an electron. Electrical field is acting from the lower plate to top plate. If your charge is placed inside an uniform magnetic field, then the charge will be experiencing a force. Already we have studied. So what is the force experienced? Generally, force experienced is F is equal to E into Q. Since the electrical field E is equal to F divided by Q, I can consider the force experience is equal to E into Q. Here, the charge is considered to be electron. So I can say for electron, the force experience will be equal to capital E multiplied with an electron that is having a charge minus E. So the force experienced by the electron is given by F is equal to E into E. If you are considering F is equal to E into E, what is the direction in which the force is acting? The force is acting in the same direction as that of what? As that of the electrical field if the charge is positive. If the charge is negative, then it will be acting in the downward direction. So that was represented by minus. So instead of F, if I am writing it as F vector, then that F vector will be equal to minus of E into J cap. And so in the negative y axis, the force is acting. So I'm writing here, as we know from mechanics, that force F is equal to mass into acceleration. I can write mass into acceleration is equal to minus of E into E. If you are putting it in terms of the vector quantity, then I can put J cap. Or otherwise, first of all, I will be calculating the magnitude and then I will get the direction. See, from this equation, I can get acceleration is equal to minus of E into E divided by M. On what direction that acceleration is acting? Acceleration is acting in the same direction as that of the force. So we can write like this, E into E divided by M multiplied it with J. So minus of J cap. Or I can say the acceleration vector is equal to minus of E into E divided by M into J cap. This is, we are calling it out as the acceleration that was acting on the electron when the electron is moving inside what? When the electron is moving inside the electrical field. What is the second concept asked? The second concept asked is velocity. what is the velocity after a time of 3 seconds. That is velocity means we have to calculate the final velocity. So the second concept that was being asked is velocity. So what is the velocity? See, from equations of motion, we know that velocity v is equal to u plus at. We know here the initial velocity u equal to v0, and acceleration was being given as a is equal to minus of e into e divided by m multiplied with, if it is vector quantity, then I have to put it as j cap. Similarly, initial velocity is along the x-axis, positive x-axis, so I can put it out as I cap. Now take this value and substitute it here. What will be your answer? Therefore, v is equal to, instead of u, you will be getting v0 plus, instead of a, you can write minus of e into e divided by m multiplied it with the t. On simplifying, we can get the velocity v is equal to v0 minus e into e divided by m into t. If you are putting it as v vector, see, I can write v0 acting along the positive x-axis. So v0 into I cap minus, this I can write e into e divided by m into t acting along the negative y-axis. So already you are having minus, so I am putting it as j cap. So if I am considering the velocity in terms of vector notation, the velocity in terms of vector notation is given by v0 of I cap minus e into e divided by m into t j cap. This is the second concept. What is the third one? The third one is we have to calculate the position with respect to time. The third one that I have to calculate is position with respect to, or position with respect to time. See, position, in order to calculate the position with respect to time, I am going for the second equation of motion. We know that S is equal to ut plus half into at square. So S is equal to, what is u? Yes, here I am considering like this. Here I am considering S as r vector. That is the position with respect to time. Then initial velocity, u is equal to v0. As we know, acceleration a is equal to minus of e into e divided by m. And take t as t. Take all these values and substitute it here. First of all, r equal to, instead of v, I am getting v0 into t. Then plus half into acceleration minus of e into e divided by m multiplied with t square. What is the value of r? R equal to v0 into t minus half into e divided by m into t square. If I am writing it as r cap, then I can write v0 into t, v0 acting along the x-axis, positive x-axis, so plus I cap, minus of half into e divided by m into t square along the y-axis, so j cap. It is acting in the negative direction, so here you are having minus. So from this, we have calculated the position of what? The position of the particle, or the position of the electron after a time of t seconds with respect to time. This we are taking it as the concept regarding the exercise problem 6. Hope you should have understood. Let us move on to the problem number 7. Come on, we are going to see about the next problem, problem number 7. A diagram is being given. A wedge-shaped object is taken, and that wedge-shaped object is placed inside an uniform electrical field E, and you are asked to calculate the electrical flux. Let us see. See, a closed triangular box is kept in an electric field of magnitude E equal to 2 into 10 to the power of 3 Newton per Coulomb. This is as shown in the figure. And you are asked to calculate the electrical flux through the vertical rectangular surface, then the slanting surface, and the entire surface. You see, what it is given, a closed triangular box in the form of an wedge is kept in an electrical field of magnitude. So the electrical field that was being available is 2 into 10 to the power of 3 Newton per Coulomb. Okay, which is as shown in the figure. You are asked to calculate the electrical flux phi of E along the phi of E in vertical rectangular surface, along the vertical rectangular surface. The first thing that you have to calculate. The second one, again, you are asked to calculate flux along the electrical field or flux of the electrical or electrical flux due to the slanting surface. This is the second one. And third one, the electrical flux for what? For the entire box or for the entire surface. These three were being asked. First of all, let us consider the vertical surface. What is that vertical surface? The vertical surface is the thing that is available behind this block. See, when you are considering like this in three dimension, the surface that is available behind to that of this block is called to be the vertical surface. See, in general, how you can able to write? In general, we can say, okay, in general, we can consider the flux available, phi E is equal to closed integral of E into dA into cos theta. Or I can say flux phi E is equal to E into, on because E is a constant, on integrating dA, you will be able to get A into cos theta. See, for the rectangular surface, you have to calculate what is the value of A. For rectangular surface, the area, we can write it out as length into breadth. What is length and what is breadth? Length is 15 centimeter and breadth is considered to be 5 centimeter. So I can write 15 into 10 to the power of minus 2 meter into breadth. I can consider the height, that is 5 centimeter, 5 into 10 to the power of minus 2. So the area is equal to 75 into 10 to the power of minus 4 meter square as its area. Then take this and substitute here. What is theta? See here, theta equal to 0. What is theta? Theta is angle between, angle between the normal drawn to surface, and the electrical field, E vector. See, when you are drawing normal to the surface, this normal to the surface and the electrical field are parallel to each other. So theta becomes 0. You take all these values and substitute it here. What is the flux available then? Flux available, phi of E equal to, what is E? E is 2 into 10 to the power of minus 3 multiplied it with area. Area is 75 into 10 to the power of minus 4 into, we are able to get cos 0. Cos 0, we can take it out as 1. So on multiplication, you can get phi of E equal to 75 into 2, we will be getting 150 into, here 10 power minus 4, and this is 10 power plus 3, isn't it? Yes, 2 into 10 power plus 3. So on multiplying, I can get 10 power minus 1. So the final answer is flux, electrical flux for the vertical rectangular surface is equal to 15 Newton meter square per Coulomb. This is the answer for the first subdivision. that is electrical flux through the vertical rectangular closed surface. This is the first subdivision. Come on, let us go for the second subdivision. Phi E, that is electrical flux for the slanting surface. So I am considering for slanting surface. If you want to calculate the electrical flux for slanting surface, the same formula I have to apply. That is the general formula. So we know the flux available phi E is equal to electrical field E into A into cos theta. Here we can write theta equal to 60 degree. See from the diagram, the slanting surface is inclined at an angle of 60 degree to the vertical. So angle theta equal to 60 degree. What is the area of slanting surface? Area of slanting or slanted surface. So area of the slanted surface is length of the slanted surface into breadth of the slanted surface. Length into breadth. See, the breadth is given. What is that breadth? Breadth is equal to 15 centimeter. 15 into 10 to the power of minus 2 meter. How to calculate the length? In order to calculate the length, see this one. This is considered to be the length of the slanting surface. You consider the right angle triangle. So in this right angle triangle, if you want, you can name this end as A, this end as B, this is C, this is D, and let us consider this as F. So BC is considered to be the length of the surface. How to calculate that BC? From the triangle ABC, you calculate cos theta. Cos theta is adjacent side by hypotenuse. Adjacent side, we can consider it as AB, and hypotenuse, I can take it out as BC. On cross multiplying, BC is equal to AB divided by cos theta, which is equal to AB divided by cos 60. What is AB? AB is 5 centimeter. So I can write BC is equal to 5 divided by 1 by 2. That is equal to 10 centimeter. Or BC is equal to length of the slanting surface is equal to 10 into 10 power minus 2 meter. So I can calculate area. What is the value of area then? Area is equal to length into breadth. What is length? Length is 10 into 10 to the power of minus 2 into. What is breadth? It is 5 into 10 to the power of minus 2. So 50 into 10 to the power of minus 4 meter square as the area. Take these values and substitute. Therefore, the electrical flux that is available, phi of E is equal to, what is E? E is taken to be 2 into 10 to the power of 3, multiplied it with, what is area? It is 50 into 10 to the power of minus 4, multiplied it with, again, what is the value of theta? You can write it out as cos 60. So what will be your answer? Your answer will be, you can able to get, what is your answer? You can able to get it out as phi of E is equal to. Okay, we have to calculate what? We have to calculate the value of phi of E. See, here I have made a mistake. What mistake? The breadth is considered to be 15. I have written it as 5. Here it is 15. If it is 15, then this value is 150 into 10 to the power of minus 4. So here also I have to change. 150. On substitution, I have made a mistake. Instead of 50, I have substituted 5. So you convert it. Now, what is phi of E? See, phi of E is equal to 2 into 150 into cos 60 is 1 divided by 2 into 10 to the power of minus 1. Here 1, 2, and this 2 will get cancelled. This 0 and this 10 power minus 1 will get cancelled. So what is the value of flux? Phi E for the slanting surface is equal to, again, 15 newton meter square per coulomb. This we are taking it as what? This we are considering it as flux available for the slanting surface. What is the third one that we have to go? The third one is the electrical flux that is available for what? The electrical flux that is available for the entire surface. See, when you are considering the entire surface, the area vector is perpendicular to that of the electrical field. That is, the normal drawn to the area and the electrical field lines are perpendicular to each other. See, we can write in two ways. See, the area vector, is perpendicular to electrical field E vector, or the normal drawn to the area, is perpendicular to the electrical field E. Therefore, we can write theta equal to 90 degree. So cos theta will become zero. Therefore, the total flux available due to the entire surface is also equal to what? Is also equal to zero. So this is the third concept that we are having. So this is the second one, and this is considered to be the third one. So these three are considered to be the answers for the asked questions. That is, one is the electrical flux for the vertical rectangular surface. Electrical flux for the vertical rectangular surface is 15 Newton meter square per coulomb. Then for the slanting surface, in order to calculate for the slanting surface, you calculate the length of the slanting surface using the triangle. And after calculating the length, you calculate the phi of E or the flux. And finally, for the entire surface, when you are considering the entire surface, the area vector, that is the normal drawn to the area, is always perpendicular to that of the direction of the electrical field. And so the theta becomes 90, cos 90 becomes zero. If cos 90 is zero, the flux available through that area, entire surface, is again equal to zero. Hope you should have understood this. Hope you might have understood, isn't it? See, in problem number 8, two graphs are being given. Both the graphs are relating the potential V with respect to that of the displacement. What it is asked? See, the electric potential is given as a function of X in figure A as well as in figure B. The first one is the figure A, and the second one considered to be figure B. Calculate the corresponding electrical fields in the region A, B, C, and D. Then plot the electrical field as a function for X for figure B. First of all, let us consider figure A. So let us take for figure A. What they have asked, calculate the corresponding electrical fields in the different regions A, B, C, D. See, we know that the electrical field E is equal to minus of dV by dr, or we can write dV divided by dx. The relationship between what? The relationship between the potential difference and the distance. See, for in case of figure A, for the region A, I am calculating. In case of region A, what is the change in electrical potential dV? Final minus initial. So final minus initial means plus, the final is plus 5, initial is 8, and it is in the decreasing order. So I can write final potential is 5, initial potential is 8. So 5 minus 8, I can able to get the answer as minus 3 volt. What is the displacement dx? The displacement dx is, say, from 8 it is 0, 0 to 0.2. So I am getting 0.2 minus 0. I will be getting it as 0.2 meters. Then what is the electrical field E then? The electrical field E is minus of dV. dV is minus 3 divided by dx is 0.2. So I can write 3 divided by 0.2, or I can get the answer as 15 volt per meter is considered to be the electrical field in case of A. So I am writing it as E of A, which is equal to 15 volt per meter. Similarly, I am considering the part, second part. This is the first part. Then next one, for the region B. What is for the region B? Let us consider. For the region B, again, I am calculating what is the dV and what is dx. In case of region B, it is, the graph is flat, 5 volt. So there is no change in the potential, so zero. And the dx is 0.4 minus 0.2. 0.4 minus 0.2, that is equal to 0.2 meter. As we know, the electrical field E is equal to minus of dV divided by dx. Since dV is equal to zero, the total electrical field itself is zero. So electrical field in the region B is equal to zero. This is the second subdivision. Then what is the third one? The electrical field for the region C. So I am writing for the region C. If you are considering the region C, come on, what is the change in potential dV? You can see the final potential is 7 and the initial potential is considered to be 5. So final 7, initial is 5 volt. So the change in potential is 2 volt. What is the change in distance? The change in distance is from 0.4 to 0.6. So 0.6 minus 0.2, which is 0.4. Isn't it? 0.6 minus 0.4. So you'll be getting 0.2. What is the electrical field then? Electrical field in the region C is equal to minus of dV is 2 divided by 0.2, which is equal to minus of 10 volt per meter. This we are taking it as electrical field in the region what? Electrical field in the region C. Then what is the final one? The final for the region D. When you are considering the region D, what is the change in potential dV? Change in potential is, here you see, the final value is considered to be what? Final value is considered to be plus 1. And the initial value is considered to be 7. So I am writing final, it is 1 minus 7. I will be able to get minus of 6 volt. See, from this position to this position, D. Now, what is this dx? Dx is 0.6 and 0.8. So 0.8, final it is 0.8 minus initial it is 0.6. We will be able to get it out as 0.2 meter. Now, what you will able to get for dV by dx? E is equal to minus of dV divided by dx, which is equal to minus of minus 6 divided by 0.2. So I can get the electrical field E is equal to 30 volt per meter. 30 volt per meter. This we are taking, or this we are considering it as the electrical field in the region what? Electrical field in the region D. Similarly, I have to get for what? Similarly, I have to get for the second one also. What is the second one? So when I am considering the second one, I am marking like this. The 0 to this rise 30, I am marking that as 1. Then from 30 to 0, I am marking this region as 2. Then here 2 to 3, I am marking that region as 3. Then 3 to minus 30, I am marking that region as 4. Then from minus 30 to 0, I am marking that region as 5. So using the same formula, so I am writing in case of figure B, I am using the same formula, E is equal to minus of dV divided by dx for different regions. So in case of region 1, what is the electrical flux? Sorry, what is the electrical field? E equal to minus of, what is the change? Final it is 30, initial it is 0. So 30 minus 0, I will be able to get minus 30 divided by what is the displacement 0 to 1. So dx I am considering it as 1. So what will be the answer for region 1? It is minus 30 volt per meter. Similarly, I am calculating for region 2. Come on, use the same formula for region 2. What is the electrical field? Electrical field E is equal to minus of. You see, final it is 0, initial it is 30. So final minus initial, it is minus 30 volt divided by what is the change? 1 to 2. The change is again 1. So I will be able to get the answer as minus of minus will become plus. You will be able to get 30 volt per meter. Then I am calculating it for region 3. See, when you are considering region 3, electrical field E is equal to 0. Since the change in electrical potential dV equal to 0. Then I am calculating region 4. See, in case of region 4, I am taking the electrical field E is equal to minus of. What is the final value? Final value is minus 30. Initial value is 0. Minus 30 minus 0, I will be able to get it out as minus 30 divided by change in displacement is what? Change in displacement is 1. So I will be able to get it as 1, and it is 30 volt per meter again in case of region 4. Then in case you calculate or you consider in case of region 5. See, in case of region 5, what is the value of electrical field E? Electrical field E is equal to minus of. Final it is 0. Initially it is minus 30. So 0 minus of minus 30, you will be getting plus 30 divided by the displacement is 5 to 4 or 4 to 5. So it is considered to be 1, and the final answer minus 30 volt per meter. Now we have to represent this in an diagram which is having what? Which is having the electrical field along what? The electrical field with respect to distance. So how I can able to get electrical field with, see, it was being asked like this: plot the electrical field as a function of x. So how to plot electrical field as a function of x? Here I am drawing. See, this voltage with the distance can be converted into electrical field with the distance. So along x-axis, I am considering x in centimeter, isn't it? So then all the units are considered to be in centimeter. In figure B, in region 1, electrical field is considered to be in centimeter, 30 volt per centimeter. Here also it is volt per centimeter. Here also it is volt per centimeter. So x in centimeter, and along the y-axis you calculate the electrical field E, which is considered to be volt per centimeter. What should be the answers? See, you are having minus 30, then plus 30, 0, etc. So at the center, okay, at the center I am considering what? At the center I am considering a line which is considered to be 0 volt per meter. In the positive y-axis, I am taking 10 volt per centimeter. Then this is 20 volt per centimeter, and this is 30 volt per centimeter. Similarly, in the negative y-axis, here minus 10 volt per centimeter, here minus 20 volt per centimeter, and here minus 30 volt per centimeter. How you have to draw that diagram? See, in order to draw the diagram, you consider the equation number 1 or region number 1. Electrical field is minus 30 volt per meter. When minus 30 volt per meter is 0 to 1. So along the x-axis also, I can mark the distance. This is 1 centimeter. This is 2 centimeter. This is 3 centimeter. This is 4 centimeter. And this is 5 centimeter. Now you mark, see, from 0 to 1. Okay, for 0 to 1, the distance is 1, 0 to here, 0 to 1. The electrical field is minus 30. So here it is. So from minus 30 to 1, 1 up to 1 distance 1, it is considered to be minus 30. Then what happens? In region 2, it increases to plus 2, plus 30 volts per centimeter. Plus 30 volt is 1 to 2. So plus 30 volt is 1 to 2. Okay. Then when you are considering 3 to 2 to 3, 2 to 3 electrical field is considered to be 0. Then this line you can able to draw. Then from 3 to 4, 3 to 4, you see it is again 30. So again 30 means plus 30 means 3 to 4. I can again draw. Then what is 4 to 5? 4 to 5 is again minus 30. So here I will be able to get. Now you join. See 0 to 1 is minus 30. Rising up to what? Rising up to plus 30. At plus 30 is from 1 to 2. When it is getting down, it becomes 0 from 2 to 3. Then it rises to plus 30 from 3 to 4. Then again from 3 to 4, it is dropping down to minus 30. This is the diagram what we can able to draw for electrical field with what? With the distance. This is the corresponding diagram for the electrical field and the distance from potential and distance from the figure B. Hope you should have understood this. If you are having any doubt, make a comment in your comment box. I will try to explain it again. But there is no difficulty in understanding this. After calculating the electrical field numerically, you just take that and plot it in the graph and join all the points so that you can able to get the graph in a neat manner. Hope you should have understood this. Let us meet in the next video regarding the one word questions. All other videos I have posted in YouTube and also posted in the group. So regarding the one word questions that I have to discuss, the one word questions in back of your book, that I will discuss it in the next two videos. And shortly, it will be reaching you. Until then, goodbye and thank you from Ravi Shankar. Thank you.